Now that we have covered engine oils, I want to switch over to automatic transmission fluids. It is important to keep in mind that my previous discussion regarding top quality base oils and additive packages are just as relevant when discussing automatic transmission fluids. The basic fluid requirements of an ATF are pretty straightforward and in many ways mirror the properties of oil in that they need to clean, lubricate, and have oxidation resistance. In addition, they include anti-foaming and friction-reducing properties. Auto manufacturers are requiring transmission builders to supply more efficient gearboxes, which require higher performance fluids, so we see a change to fluids that are requiring more specific qualities. I believe most of you are familiar with some of the more common ones: Toyota WS and the T4, DEC 6, Honda DW1, and so on. As we look at the growing popularity of CVTs, it is important to know that in terms of fluid, CVT and automatic transmission share all but one of the fluid requirements. Regular automatic transmission fluids have friction-reducing properties, whereas a CVT fluid needs to enhance or increase the levels of friction because it is belt-driven. I have seen in the past, and I believe that there is again in the marketplace, a fluid or fluids that tout their ability to be used in both regular automatic transmissions and CVTs. Although it might work for a while, it is not possible for fluids to have both friction reducing and friction enhancing properties. So beware. Just a few more words regarding CVTs. For those of you that don't know how a CVT works, here's a simple illustration of the belt and pulleys. Hydraulic pressure forces the pulleys in or out to give the transmission an infinite range of gear ratios. Their growing popularity is due to improved fuel economy, smooth driving experience, and allows the engines to operate at optimal power. I want to talk about transmission fluid specifications. A long time ago, when many of the vehicles were manual transmissions and used a gear oil, those specifications were set again by API. It might surprise some of you to know that unlike engine oil and gear oil, there are no industry standards for automatic transmission fluid and CVT fluid. But OEMs do require specific fluids, especially when it comes to viscosity. Essentially, ATF is a hydraulic fluid, and when used in a hydraulic automatic transmission, even a high viscosity fluid will allow the transmission to operate. However, a higher viscosity fluid will certainly negatively impact performance and fuel economy. So as a result of changing and increasingly dedicated specifications, we see more specific fluids. This graph illustrates the viscosity trend that is and has been taking place with the OEMs. On the left, with automatic transmission fluids, you can see the older specifications at the top, with Nissan Matic J, the Toyota T4, for example, have given way to Honda DW1, Toyota WS, the Nissan Matic S, which are all lower viscosity. And on the right, the same with CVT fluids, with the older Subaru, the Nissan NS2, and the older Hondas have given way to lower viscosity fluids like the NS3 for Nissan and Toyota FE. So just like engine oil, lowering the viscosity of transmission fluids can help increase fuel economy in vehicles, and then the advanced additive packages are needed to ensure the transmissions are still protected. I got the idea for this viscosity chart a few years ago while making sales calls. One shop that I was at had just received a drum of brand A ATF that touted its ability to be used in pretty much everything. The owner then produced the spec sheet for the product, and when I saw the listed viscosity, it was very high and nowhere near what the OEMs required. When I asked him if he understood what the numbers represented, he did not. He only understood that it could be used in everything. So this chart shows that starting with our Eco ATF and its associated viscosity, that represents a true low EM viscosity, that when you go down the list of some of the more popular fluids, you can see how they are increasing in viscosity. On the far right, you can see as a percentage how much higher in viscosity they are. I also see some brands in the marketplace advertising a low viscosity fluid, but is only low relative to the other fluids that they produce. They still don't achieve what the OEM requires. Make no mistake, it will work, but will not allow the vehicle to operate at its design performance. Transmissions are becoming more complex and more sophisticated than ever, so OEMs can boast more power and lower fuel consumption. It is not possible anymore to recommend a fluid that applies to all transmission types. So in the end, why do you need ENEOS for your Asian car? We know that GM and other domestic manufacturers, as well as Euro car makers, have published specifications for their engines. Well, so do the OEMs for Asian manufacturers. However, these are not published. Factory fill oils are developed to meet the OEM standards, as well as API, ILSAC, and JSO specifications. Most service fill oil in the market is primarily based on API, ILSAC, and JSO, and will not have the specific OEM requirements. So in the end, ENEOS is your best choice.